I'm Sarah.
And I'm Rocky.
We're Savage Disney Pins. And we are here for day two of our Disney treat weekend.
Now, yesterday we tackled my favorite park treat, which are the peanut butter cookies.
Today we're going to tackle my favorite treat. We found a copycat recipe for churro toffee. If you have never had churro toffee, it's incredible. I generally bring home 2 or 3 pieces when we come home from a trip, just so I have some to snack on.
I typically find there are two type of people that like churro toffee. People with taste buds, people that are breathing.
So good. We'll see how this goes. I had to buy a candy thermometer. I'm a little terrified of this. I've never used one before.
So the churro toffee is chock full of healthy vitamins and essential minerals. Let's show you what exactly is going into this.
Here's all the ingredients.
Unlike yesterday, where we did a lot of stuff on the counter, most of today's activities are going to happen right back here on the stove. So we're going to measure success a couple different ways. First, if we have passable churro toffee is definitely a plus. And if I can walk through this whole endeavor without third-degree burns.
Okay, the very first instruction I think is pretty easy. Take your pan and you put parchment paper on it.
No burns so far. Any paper cuts?
No paper cuts.
We're injury free thus far.
We're gonna set this aside, and then once the sugar is done boiling, we'll be able to pour it in here.
Should I wash this off?
Yeah. Okay. Position tip into mid-level of liquid. I don't know where mid-level is gonna be, but I'm assuming that it's gonna be like halfway. Oy vey. Okay. Okay, place butter, sugar, and salt in a large saucepan. Butter, sugar, teaspoon of kosher salt is it. We need to be really careful now because we're gonna watch as this heats up. The butter and the sugar are gonna melt and then it's gonna start to boil. And when it reaches 285 degrees, we have to pull it off really quick, or else it'll burn.
Should I get a fire extinguisher ready?
Probably. Okay.
Yesterday's treats. This recipe is not for the impatient. So I just realized our fatal flaw with making all of the Disney treats while we're locked in the house. We don't have the step count associated with, you know, the 10 miles on average we put on a day at the park.
To work it off?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No burns so far.
Okay, so the instructions say, after letting this sit for a couple minutes, take a plastic knife and cut through so that you can get the squares like they have at Disneyland. So I am cutting these smaller than at Disneyland. Because the ones in the park are really massive. It also says you may have to go over these lines 4 or 5 times.
Buttery.
I don't know. No idea. Okay, now we are going to refrigerate it. We'll see you back in 20 minutes. 20 minutes is up. We'll see how they turn out. Very greasy. I think we're just gonna try and pull them apart.
All right, let's do it.
Okay, these are really, really greasy. So we're gonna use the old pizza technique. Sop up some of this butter. Oh, hey!
Look at that.
Cool. That actually broke apart really easily. They're not the prettiest. Yeah, I don't know how fragile they are. I think they're, oh.
They look pretty sturdy. Yeah, well, they're pretty sturdy. Chocolate time?
Chocolate time. We got some white chocolate chips. Just gonna melt them in the microwave. Okay, that's two bags. I have a third bag in case we need a little bit more, but we'll start with this.
True culinary masters use microwaves. Not your first time melting chocolate in the microwave?
I just watch a lot of baking shows. Down here, I have cooling rack over some parchment paper. That way, when we dip these in, we can lay them on here and then they'll drip.
Okay.
Down onto here.
First attempt.
That's so thick. Get to the other side. Okay, hang on. There we go. That's okay, we can kind of sprinkle it. If whatever doesn't stick will just come off.
Okay.
You can probably put more on there. Those look pretty good. We'll see how they come out. We have to let them sit in the fridge for at least another 40 minutes so that the chocolate can firm up.
Okay. All right. It's been 40 minutes. Moment of truth. Were we able to pull this off?
Okay. Let's see how they came out.
Well, visually, it lacks some of the finesse that we see on the ones in the park.
They're not very pretty.
All right.
There we go.
All right. How is it?
It was really good.
I should just grab my own then?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I would almost say it tastes more churro than toffee.
Not bad.
Very good.
Mm-hmm. I think it's pretty successful. 2 out of 2 snacks.
Yeah, it definitely tastes like them.
Mm-hmm. If you guys want to give it a go, we'll post the recipe down in the description.
Mm-hmm.
You can try it yourself. Pretty damn good.
They're pretty on the money, yeah.
Well, this was a fun weekend, and we need to go...
Run 10 miles?
Run 10 miles to work all this sugar off.
So much sugar.
Well, thanks again for watching.
If you enjoyed this video, click the like below. And for more content, hit subscribe.
Bye.
Just do something. Stop staring at me.